Lord, use me, the adventures of Francis.
Fight! one, the early rounds. That strange name stuck. Francis, it means Frenchman. All Mother Pekka could do was love her son and wean him on stories of God's saints. Francis grew up with one foot in the church and one foot in Daddy's store. By his early teens, Francis' feet touched French soil on Father's business trips, but that was just his feet. In Francis' head were visions of dragons and knights, armor and honor. He longed to be noble, and on his lips were songs. Francis' voice charmed everyone, everyone. So who won the fight for Francis? The battle was not over, but this is certain. Young Francis became a fine salesman in Dad's store, selling fine fabrics. And Francis wore fine clothes. And when night came, Francis gave fine parties. He bought fine food. He sang fine songs with that fine voice. For everyone, he bought fine wine. At night, everyone loved Francis. They followed, they listened, they sang along, they swallowed it all, and they were sure, life is fine for Francis.
Stumbled in.
I'm a poor soul. Do you have any gift for the love of
furious. He threw the beggar out of the store. But then the words echoed in his ears.
For the love of God.
Suddenly, Francis remembered Jesus' words.
Whatever you do to the least, you do to me.
Francis realized
he had thrown God out.
Francis ran out, found the beggar, and filled her surprised hands with silver coins. Francis was being changed. He wasn't the party boy anymore. He looked at himself, and he was cut to the heart. He begged God's forgiveness. Once on a road, he met a leper covered with sores. The young Francis would have stayed away, but the changed Francis kissed the leper. It made Francis so happy he started to sing. Later, Francis put on the clothes of a beggar and walked to Rome. At the altar of St. Peter, he poured out all the money he carried. Francis had always been generous, but now he was determined to give everything away. Then came the event that would change Francis forever. He was praying in a rundown little chapel. When suddenly, a figure of Jesus painted on the cross spoke to him.
Francis, repair my church.
Francis went to his father's store, grabbed a bolt of precious fabric, ran to the next town and sold it. Now he had money to repair the little chapel. Francis also had a furious father.
Missing, what am I to feel like? Princess John is missing. Did you chase her down?
wondering what to do.
What to do? What to do?
His father is mad. He wants his cloth back, his money back, and especially his son, the salesman, back. He is mad.
Mad, mad, mad!
The bishop has been called to set everyone straight.
Poor bishop. Everyone love, give thanks.
witnessed this man touched by God, and some people decided to follow the way of Francis.
Follow Francis? Why?
Good question. Followers of Francis owned only a few clothes. They could have had no money. Following Francis meant working for food or begging. They often slept on the ground.
No money? Work for food? Begging? Why did they do it?
Like Francis, they wanted to teach about Jesus by words and actions. They found peace in the simple life of faith. They liked traveling light through this world, and they loved being around Francis. Francis called them his brothers. The brothers wore simple brown robes like Francis. People called the brothers God's sparrows.
There you are, Brother Wolf.
Huh? I'm the bad wolf. I'm the bad wolf. No one's ever called me Brother Wolf.
You have been a bad wolf. God made those people that you ate. That needs to stop.
But a wolf gets hungry. I get really hungry. I get really, really, really hungry. And those goobers are really slow. easy to catch. A little noisy, but some of them are pretty tasty.
God said, no more eating goobers. I mean people.
No more goobers. No more goobers. So what am I supposed to eat?
Come with me. Citizens of Gubbio, listen. If they feed you, will you stop eating them?
Sounds reasonable.
Will you feed the wolf if he stops eating you?
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Gee, thanks, goobers.
My work here is done. God kept using Francis, and Francis became more and more famous. Thousands of people heard him preach. His brother sparrows traveled all over Europe and North Africa, sharing the love of Jesus and Francis's way of peace. Francis even preached to the birds and all the animals. The animals loved Francis. People loved Francis. It seemed like everyone loved Francis.
We are the Francis.
and Francis understood God was using him. But one thing Francis could not understand was how can anyone not love Jesus?
Not love Jesus?
We must not know Jesus. If you know Jesus, you're going to love him.
That was why Francis told about Jesus to anyone who would listen. One day, Francis was wondering,
where could God use me most?
Suddenly, Francis knew. Across the sea, an army of crusaders was fighting to take whole land from the Muslims. The leader of the Muslims was the Sultan. So, Francis thought it'd be simple.
All I need to do is go talk to the Sultan, tell him about Jesus, then he'll become a Christian. Then the Bible stops. What better way could God use me to have?
So that is what Francis did. He sailed to Egypt. He found the army of crusaders, camped outside the city of Sultan. But when Francis saw the crusaders' army, he realized,
these people are disgusting.
So Francis needed to first convert the crusaders. He preached about Jesus and many of them were changed people. But Francis knew there was more to his mission.
Thank you. By torches.
Torches! 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 Torches!
The torches are guiding seemingly everyone from the town and the surrounding area to this cave. Reportedly, the controversial madman, Francis of Assisi, is holed up inside. What is he hiding in that cave? It could be drugs.
We don't think so.
It could be weapons.
We don't think so.
It could be his personal harem.
Ha ha ha.
Let's see if we can get a word from one of these ignorant masses marching like zombies towards this cave. You, ma'am, you look calm and ignorant. What propels you up this mountainside on this dark and cold December night outside Grecia?
We're going to church.
Church?
Church, Harold! No! Church! Church!
Harold, it's Christmas Eve. We're going to church.
Church.
Francis invited us to join him.
What treacherous surprise is awaiting these ignorant masses? Will Francis summon a spaceship?
Yeah, right.
Has he found a Sasquatch, the legendary Bigfoot?
For sure.
Or is that cave the source of the Fountain of Youth?
Hell no!
Let's move in closer.
Christmas Eve in the year of our Lord. That are still with us. The fishing will be seen in the first midnight mass. Francis was tired.
So tired!
God had used Francis to establish a brotherhood of his followers. God had used Francis to travel around his homeland and to Holy Land, even to the Sultan, to tell everyone who would listen.
God loves you. Jesus is our Savior.
God loves us!
Francis was ready to go home to his Lord. He started to call death, brother death. Then God put a final seal upon Francis's life. It happened when Francis was praying on a mountainside. Suddenly, he was given the stigmata.
Stigmata? What's that?
The stigmata are the wounds Jesus had on the cross. Like Jesus, Francis had wounds on his hands. Hands.
Inside.
Holly Blanc is shown to have been singing this prayer, Lord, please use me. This morning, God certainly has used him to deliver God's word to us. Thank you to all of you music campers. As they can tell you, we memorized two rules this week. Rule number one is?
Listen.
And rule number two is?
Be kind.
We didn't make up those rules just for this week. Those are words that Jesus gave to us. He told us to listen. He told us to be kind. Francis kept being used by God because he kept listening. And Francis kept disarming others and drawing them in because he was kind to everyone. How will God use these young people and use you and me in the days ahead? That is part of the adventure and mystery of our faith. If we keep listening, if we keep being kind, the Lord will use us. Please stand and receive the benediction. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now let's join in the prayer, the life, and the song. Lord, please use me.